I love breakfast food. Doesn't matter which cuisine, I love breakfast food for breakfast, for lunch, or for dinner. So this is my take on a Malaysian breakfast. I'm gonna make a fishball congee, and I'm gonna flavor that with some strong flavors of ginger, lemongrass, some chili paste, something to wake you up in the morning.
I use short grain rice. Their starch content and round shape make for a great porridge.
When I have congee, I want to taste the ginger. I want to bite into it. So what I'm gonna do is just cut these into really small squares. That way you can get a nice hit of ginger for every spoonful that you take. Nice. Now to this, I'm gonna add some lemongrass. But of course, I don't really wanna bite into lemongrass. It's very fibrous. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take away the outer leaves. There you go.
I pound the lemongrass stalks to release the flavors, and I leave them whole to make them easy to fish out later.
That's it. That way I can easily fish this out of my congee once it's cooked. I'm also gonna add some minced garlic, so I have that ready. And we can start. I'm gonna start with a little bit of oil. A traditional congee will probably have you just dump everything together and then just boil it. But I wanna toast our aromats just to give it more flavor. All right, oil is nice and ready. Ginger, lemongrass, and then lots of garlic. That's the Pinoy in me. You always love garlic in the morning. Oh, that smells good already. Now I'm gonna add in our rice early. I want them to be coated in that ginger, lemongrass, garlic oil. I'm just gonna go by feel. That's probably good enough. So we're gonna toast the rice a little bit, almost like when you're making a paella or, for example, a risotto. You wanna toast it, coat it in the oil.
Once all the grains are coated in the oil, I add in the liquid. I add a combination of chicken stock and water to balance out the flavors.
And I want my porridge to be light tasting. Very fragrant, but light tasting. That's good for now. Okay, this will probably go for about 15 to 17 minutes until the rice is really cooked. So I'm just gonna let that go and simmer for about 13 minutes, then I'm gonna come back and stir it. Okay, it's beginning to boil now, so I'm gonna lower the heat to a simmer. And meanwhile, I have my fish balls here. And these fish balls are pretty much cooked. So what I can do is just slice them up, and then at the last minute, I'm just gonna add them. I have this thing about soups and porridges. I like everything to fit inside a spoon. I mean, you're gonna eat it with a spoon, right? So make sure everything fits.
We're ready.
Take a look. Ah, nice. The rice has gotten fat and happy, like me. And now they've infused with that flavor from the ginger, from the lemongrass, from the garlic. And now I'm gonna add in our fish balls and then let that soak in the liquid as well. Now, what I'm gonna do is for the last few minutes of cooking, I'm actually gonna stir this. And what will happen is some of my stirring motion will actually crush some of the rice, giving it that texture from the Hong Kong style porridge. This is so fragrant. I'm gonna do a little bit of a taste test now, right before this finishes cooking. Oh, look at that. A little bit of that rice starch is out. That's why it's thicker than what it was before. Okay. Ah, that's perfect. I don't need to add any more salt. You know, sometimes the fish boil can actually be salty. So, sometimes you don't need to add as much salt as you think.
A touch of black pepper, and before I forget, I remove the lemongrass stalks.
Okay, all the lemongrass stalks are out. And just as a final finish, I'm gonna add a little bit of water, just so that it's not as thick. It'll run just a little bit. That little water won't actually affect the taste, so don't worry. It's time to serve this up, and I wanna serve it up Malaysian style. Now for garnish, I'm gonna add some roasted peanuts in the middle.
Normally, peanuts would be boiled for this dish, but I like to keep them crunchy for texture.
Crunchy peanuts, a little bit of freshness from the green onion. And then, you want to give the people an option if they like things spicy, especially here in Malaysia, almost everything is spicy. So, what they usually do when they serve their noodle soups or their porridges is they give you a little bit of that chili paste onto your soup spoon. And they just serve it like that. And then it's up to you how much you want to put in it, right? And there you go.